also on the speedway will be the two of Dennis Rambo Franklin out of Gaffney, South Carolina. Hines in a Longhorn with Cornette Power, Don's Auto Sales, and Jason Ayers Trucking. Rambo Franklin, the two, also a Longhorn with Clements Power, M&W Transport, C&D Properties, and Nichols Plumbing. First lap, 13.085 for Hines, 12.421 for Rambo. 12.438 for Hines, second lap, that'll be the lap of record. Rambo goes to the top of the board, 12.150. Next car out, the 201 of Billy Ogle Jr. out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Longhorn chassis, custom race engine, Vanover & Sons Concrete, Harrison Ready Mix, Grady & King Construction, Reynolds Racing & Marine. Also on the speedway will be the 23 car out of Oneida, Tennessee. Victory Circle chassis, Phantom Race engine car. First lap for Ogle, 12.014, new fast time. Tim Darden in the 23 car, the T-Tag Trucking, El Rey's Mexican Restaurant, and West Haven Speed Equipment. His first lap, 12.952. Ogle, second lap, 12.044. And Dameron at a 12.677. Caleb Ashby in the 61 car should be the next man out of Cunningham, Tennessee. He's in the Schwartz chassis, B&B Race Engines, B. Lou Rentals, K&F Gas, and Tommy's Quality Used Cars on the side. Also on the speedway should be the 15 car of Richard Frost out of Clarksville, Tennessee, Rocket Chassis, Craig Clark Motorsports, Frost Alignment, CLM Trucking, and One Stop Motorsports. First lap for Ashby. 12.233, tough break for the 15. Yellow light on. Caution on the 15 car, so Ashby will get an extra lap, because it did impede his second lap. Ashby comes back around. 12.154 moves him third overall. So right now they're all still chasing Billy Ogle Jr. at a 12.014. Rambo second at 12.150. No stranger to Crossville Speedway, the R1 of Riley Hickman out of Ootowah, Tennessee. Capital Chassis, Vic Hill Race Engine, Hickman Manufacturing, Tucker's Mobile Home Sales, and American Billet and Brinkley Forms on the side of Riley Hickman's machine. Also on the speedway will be Van Lester in the 50 car out of Dandridge, Tennessee, Rocket Chassis, Lester Brothers Grinding on the side. First lap, Hickman, 12.051. Lester comes around, 13.576. Hickman, 12.097. Lester finishing up his second lap, coming to the line, 13.334. Hickman moves to second on the grid overall, drops Rambo back to third. Billy Ogle Jr. still the time. Everybody's chasing at a 12.014. Next out will be Chicky Barton in the 144 car out of Middlesboro, Kentucky. Rocket Chassis, Phantom Race Engine, Star Septic, Tri-State Guttering, and Yoakum Properties. Also on the speedway should be the J8 of Jaden Frame out of Winchester, Tennessee. Capital Race Car, Vic Hill Power, Russell Barnett Kia, and Poultry Electric and Pro Hardware. First lap, Barton, 12.603. Jaden Frame at a 12.148. Coming back around, Barton will turn the second lap, 12.522. Frame second lap, 12.200. 12.200. Millwood. Tyler Millwood in the 31 car out of Kingston, Georgia. He's your ultimate points leader in the Clement-powered Longhorn chassis. Millwood Plumbing on the side, along with Realty Queen and Team. Hitson and Machine Construction, Chris Madden Racing, on the side of his entry. Also on the speedway be Joey Coulter in the 2 car out of Miami Springs, Florida. Longhorn chassis, Cornet Power, Black Rifle Coffee, Simpson, and Broward Armature and Generators. First lap, Millwood, 12.200. Coulter, 12.185. Millwood off of 4, back to the line, 12.941. He had a problem there, we didn't see. Coulter to 12.116. Coulter third overall after fast time and hot laps. Car is fired. We're going to do one because he's by himself, had to get the four-wheeler. Don't want any danger there for our track official. Ross Bell's using that high side through 1 and 2. Bell's a very good qualifier everywhere he goes. May have skipped the cushion there just a little bit. First lap, 12.603. He'll try to nail it this time. Foot all the way through the firewall. Coming back to the line, is he in line for the M&W bonus? 12.260. Ross, a hard charger, may have overdrove it just a touch there. You see the line, he kind of skipped the cushion there. They like to lean that tire right on where it changes from the lighter color to the dark color. Brad Skinner, the 17 car out of Spring Hill, Tennessee, Rocket XR1, King's Custom Engine, Dixon Plumbing, AFCO Technologies, and Trace Construction on the side of the 17. Also on the speedway be the 24 of Jared Bailey out of Bedford, Indiana, Rocket Chassis, Travis Kern Race Engine, Texicon Cut Stone, CS Prototyping, Allen Norman Construction. First lap, Skinner, 13.614, Bailey, 12.818. Skinner, second lap, 13.060. Bailey second in the ultimate battle of Grew-S points, 12.810. Hello, Roger. Roger who? Hey, Roger. Jason Welshen in the 29 car, second in ultimate series points out of Maryville, Tennessee. The Longhorn chassis, Clements Power, PPM Competition Racing Equipment, Hidden Hollow Motorsports, Ronald Sexton Construction, and C&J Trucking. Also on the speedway will be the Jeff Watson number 76 entry. Welshen first lap, 12.574. Watson, 12.800. Watson out of Campbellsville, Kentucky, GRT chassis, a 604 motor underneath the hood, extreme pressure wash. Farley's Tree Service and Volunteer Muffler, second lap for Welshen, 12.371. Watson, second lap, 12.890. Brandon Overton in the 116, next car out of Evans, Georgia. Longhorn by Weaver, Andy Durham Race Engine. CrossFit Overton, AF Stone Medical, Mission Transport, and Shavers Oil. Also on the speedway will be the 31 of Kenny Cobble out of Cookeville, Tennessee. First lap, Overton, 12.484. Cobble, 12.830. Overton riding the high line through 3 and 4, coming back to the line, 12.289. Kenny Cobble, 13.149. In his Rocket chassis, B&B Performance under the hood, CNC Machining on the side. Got your stopwatch ready. Next car out and final car taking time will be Donald McIntosh in the 7 car out of Dawsonville, Georgia. Rocket chassis, Vic Hill Power, Stowers Cat, Blunt Excavating, Massey Electrical, Tennessee RV, Cherokee Millwright, Super Center. Excuse me. Here we go. First lap. 12.048. Track still has speed. McIntosh second on the grid. Can he get a couple ticks more? Going to let McIntosh get one more lap. For some reason, didn't pick up that second time. This will be the second lap for McIntosh. He'll come back to the line, take the white flag. Coming back to the line. McIntosh second on the grid at a 12.048. Billy Ogle Jr. at a 12.014. McIntosh second quick. We're going to go talk pit side, track side with the M&W Towing and Transport. Here your pole sitter night, picking up the M&W Towing and Transport $200 bonus. Miss Megan O'Shields, Miss Ultimate, will present the souvenir check for him. Folks, give it up. Billy Ogle Jr. climbing out of this machine. That's right, Billy. Expect the unexpected. Billy, come on around here. Trouble in hot laps. You had a wheel break, or what was that?
No, I was just kind of pushing it too hard. I knew I was in a push, but I thought the car would drive out. And I got up a little bit into some slime, and it just kind of just sucked me on in there. And I pounded it pretty good, and we barely got the thing back together. I knocked my right rear spoiler off, and we had to just kind of jerry-rig it back on there. But as long as it will catch some air, I think we'd be okay. I don't know, it might have helped it because it's got more angle now. Who knows?
Well, you made some right adjustments there. Wall or whatever did it right for you.
Yeah, I thought it might have knocked my alignment out because my steering wheel kind of changed a little. But we got after the tire was back on it and I took back off, it was fine. It was good.
Well, congratulations on the $200 bonus from M&W Towing and Transport. It's the Hauling Fast Time Award. What you got for the feature?
I hope I can be there for the last lap. That's the one you got to lead. I know there's some tough competition out there. I don't know. I know the 116 will be tough. McIntosh will be tough. We just got to make the right tire choice and be there at them.
Congratulations. Billy Ogle Jr. picking up the M&W Hauling It Fast Time Trial Award, $200 from M&W Transport. We thank them for being on board with us each and every week. We'll be back for our feature in just a little bit. Congratulations again, Billy.